Next question. Feel free to ask. There's a hand up all the way in the back. Feel free to ask in Mandarin. And since we're in Chinese, Teochew or Hokkien as well.
Mr. Goh, I'm from the Macca generation, and in 1980, I was around. I was not even 30 yet. So, but I was at a shock, you know, when Mr. Lee Kuan Yew talked for many nights, I remember, on television about how bad was Nanta and why, and he wanted it shut down. You know, he tried to tell the whole Singapore how bad was Nanta. I know Nanta, yeah, finish. Let's close it down. And I mean, what I'm trying to say now is, maybe this hindsight now. If Nanta still exists today, it will be a very valuable asset to Singapore because it's the first overseas Chinese university. But I mean, if you were the Prime Minister at that time, in 1980, would you be doing the same thing? Would you think that Nanta is finished? And then another question now actually was, should we start another Chinese language university in Singapore today? I got an answer before in another forum, and that was, it's difficult now because we do not have Chinese language students among us. And it will take time for the universities to get the students to join it.
Who gave you the answer?
Well, that was I attended this Zhongxiang Huiguan, the forum. So they are also talking about culture, you know. We are losing our Thai language.
Was the answer given by a minister?
No. He's not a minister, but he's a professor, I think. But he said it's difficult. Because he said, we do not have the students. And it will take time. It's difficult now to do it. But should we do it?
Okay, you have two questions. First, if I were Prime Minister, would I do things differently? If I were Prime Minister, I had a personality of Lee Kuan Yew, I would do the same as he did. So, on looking back, was he right? I think that's what you meant. Eh? Was he right in closing down Nanta? By 1980, I was already in cabinet. So I knew a little of his thinking. His concern was not closing down Nanta because there was a Chinese university. That was not his concern. Because that would be wrong totally. His concern was the deteriorating standard of university education in Nanta. In other words, Nanta started off very well, but by 1980, the standard had gone down, and it was a very emotional thing for him. So he was trying to bring it under NUS so that the two could be integrated and the standard could be raised. Of course, by doing that, you're actually pushing down further this Chinese university education. So that's the history. So would I do it differently? Of course, when you look back, if you see the future, you might do it differently. No, because you say, oh, China is going to rise. I better save Nanta. How? And we open it to other foreign students. Where? The Malaysians were already coming. Then you've got to pay more to get good professors to come. That's different, see? Because they were not able to pay the professors well. I could have made it into a national university funded by the state, because China was going to rise, and it would be so important. So on hindsight, one could of course say many things to do things differently. By that point of time, if you ask many people, Chinese educated, I do not know, you ask many others, where would China be in the year 2019? At the time, many people would say, I think they'll go nowhere. So it's very different. So the answer is, even Lee Kuan Yew, don't talk about me, Lee Kuan Yew, today with hindsight, would he have done things differently? I believe he would do things differently because of the importance of Chinese. Then you would treat it differently. You would put money into the university to sort it up. But Nanta was founded as a private university at the time. Not much support from the government. Okay, so again, being pragmatic. Do you cry? I know you cried, but no, we are all practical. You say, okay, move on. And many Ananta people I knew, they say, let's move on. No point crying over episode where they felt very emotional about it. You know, when I visited Ananta, I think by then I was probably PM, you know, it's just for a function. Oh no, sorry, I have to tell another story. Before we started NTU, Nanyang Technological University, we were trying to preserve the name Nanyang University. So that's very important. Because to preserve it for the connection that NU, Nanyang University was for them and for Singapore. So say, but this university was going to be a technological university. So the word technology must be there. Just calling it Nanyang University would not have that attraction for the new students, which is technology. So we turned around or playing around with the name. How should we call it? The obvious name is Nanyang University of Technology. That would sound very good. Nanyang University of Technology. Until we put in acronym NUT, say so that's not very good. So all the graduates are not graduates. So we could not do it. Then you say, okay, how about Technological University? No, yeah, Technological University of Nanyang. Put it the other way around. And TUN. TUN. No. You are very tuned, it's not so good. Hokkien is very good. Gramsci, you know, and so on. And also, Tun, good name in a country up north. Then they will be very angry with us because every graduate of Nanyang is a Tun. We couldn't do it. And we came up with this very difficult acronym, NTU. Even to pronounce in English is difficult. Nanyang Technological University. So it's not that we do not understand the importance of Nanyang University. We tried to compromise with Nanyang Technological University. So when I went to Nanyang later on, one of the alumni functions, they asked me the question, would you rename it Nanyang University? I was okay with it. Drop the word technology, just call it university. But the graduates of Nanyang Technological University objected. So we are graduates of NTU, not NU. So very confusing. And MOE advised against it. I actually asked MOE to consider. The faculties of Nanyang Technological University also objected. Because NTU to NU, we gave it a very different coloration and interpretation. So it's not that we did not understand the emotions of Chinese education and Nanyang University. So pragmatism, that's one illustration of pragmatism, how we move forward.
Thank you, sir. Can we have a question here from
Chao Mao? So far, okay. Yeah. This question is
it sounds like the Chao Mao story for tomorrow.
Chao Mao is more interested in current stories. This is the old story.
Wu Zhizhen, 请问呢，现在我们的传统